So what is tuberculosis? Tuberculosis, or TB for short, is caused by a bacterium called Mycobacterium tuberculosis. The bacteria usually attacks the lungs, but TB bacteria can attack any part of the body, such as the kidneys, spine, and brain. It's one of the world's deadliest diseases and is contagious, but it's curable and preventable. Two TB-related conditions exist. One, latent TB infection, known as LTBI, or two, TB disease. So what's the difference between latent TB infection and TB disease? Latent TB infection is when one has TB germs in their body, but they are not sick because the germ is not active. It also includes when they don't have symptoms of TB disease and they cannot spread the germs to others. They may develop tuberculosis disease in the future and are often prescribed treatment to prevent them from developing TB. Secondly, the TB disease is when they're sick from TB germs that are active, meaning they are multiplying and destroying tissue in their body. They usually have symptoms of tuberculosis disease, and people with TB disease of the lungs or throat are capable of spreading germs to others. They are prescribed drugs that can treat tuberculosis disease. So who's at risk for tuberculosis? The categories of persons at high risk for developing TB include 1. Persons who have been recently infected with tuberculosis bacteria. This can include close contact of a person with infectious TB, persons who have immigrated from areas of the world with high rates of TB, children less than 5 years of age who have a positive TB test, groups with high rates of TB transmission, such as homeless persons, injection drug users, and persons with HIV infection, and persons who work or reside with people who are at high risk for TB in facilities or institutions such as hospitals, homeless shelters, correctional facilities, nursing homes, and residential homes for those with HIV. Secondly, persons with medical conditions that weaken the immune system, like babies and young children who have often weak immune systems. Other people can have weak immune systems too, especially those with any of the following conditions: HIV infection, the virus that causes AIDS, substance abuse, silicosis, diabetes mellitus, severe kidney disease, low body weight, organ transplants, head and neck cancer, medical treatments such as corticosteroids or organ transplants, and specialized treatment for rheumatoid arthritis or Crohn's disease. So what is the incidence of tuberculosis in the United States? In 2016, there were a total of 9,272 TB cases that were reported just in the U.S. alone. This represents a 2.9% decrease, though, from 2015. The national incidence rate was 2.9 cases per 100,000 persons. That's a 3.6 decrease from 2015. How is tuberculosis transmitted? TB bacteria are spread through the air from one person to another, called airborne. The TB bacteria are put into the air when a person with TB disease of the lungs or throat coughs, speaks, or sings. People nearby may breathe in these bacteria and become infected. When a person breathes in TB bacteria, the bacteria can settle into the lungs and begin to grow. From there, they can move through the blood to other parts of the body, such as the kidneys, spine, and brain. Now, it's important to remember that TB is not spread by the following: shaking someone's hand, sharing food or drink, touching bed linens or toilet seats, sharing toothbrushes, or kissing. Now let's talk about the signs and symptoms of tuberculosis. Symptoms of TB disease depend on where in the body the TB bacteria are growing. TB bacteria usually grow in the lungs, known as pulmonary TB. TB disease in the lungs may cause symptoms such as a bad cough that lasts 3 weeks or longer, pain in the chest, coughing up blood or sputum, phlegm from deep inside the lungs, and other symptoms of TB disease could include weakness or fatigue, weight loss, no appetite, chills, fever, or sweating at night. Symptoms of TB disease in other parts of the body depend on the area infected. So let's talk about the testing and diagnosis of tuberculosis. There are two kinds of tests that are used to detect TB bacteria in the body. A TB skin test is one of those ways. It's also called the mantle tuberculin skin test, or TST for short. This is performed by injecting a small amount of fluid called tuberculin into the skin on the arm. A person giving the tuberculin skin test must return within 48 to 72 hours to have a trained healthcare worker look for a reaction on the arm. The result depends on the size of the raised hard area of swelling. This is the preferred TB test for children under age 5. A positive skin test means that the person's body was infected with TB bacteria. Additional tests are needed to determine if the person has latent TB infection or TB disease. A negative skin test means the person's body did not react to the test and that latent TB infection or TB disease is not likely. The second is a blood test, also called the interferon gamma release assays, or IGRAs for short. A healthcare provider will draw a patient's blood and send it to the laboratory for analysis and results. If there's a positive TB blood test, which means that the person has been infected with TB bacteria, additional tests are needed to determine if the person has latent TB infection or TB disease. If it's negative, that means that the person's blood did not react to the test and that latent TB infection or TB disease is not likely. So what would the treatment and prevention include for tuberculosis? Well, for treatment, there are 10 drugs currently approved by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration for treating TB. The CDC offers a guide for the basic treatment schedule. For prevention, we would include the BCG vaccine. The BCG is a vaccine for tuberculosis disease and is used in many countries with a high prevalence of TB to prevent childhood tuberculosis, meningitis, and miliary disease. It's recommended for children and healthcare workers. Included with the prevention of transmission of tuberculosis, educating, training, and counseling of workers, customers, and visitors about TB infection and TB disease, testing and evaluating workers who are at risk for exposure to TB disease, applying epidemiology-based prevention principles, including the use of setting related TB infection control data, coordinating efforts between local or state health departments in high-risk healthcare and congregate settings, ensuring proper cleaning, sterilization, disinfecting of equipment that might be contaminated, adequate local or general ventilation of working areas, clean air by using high-efficiency particulate air filtration, known as HEPA, or ultraviolet germicidal irradiation, using posters and signs to remind patients and staff of proper cough etiquette, which includes covering the mouth when coughing and respiratory hygiene. There is a period of communicability with TB. A person is able to spread TB from an assigned date of 3 months prior to symptom onset or a positive lab report. An individual is considered no longer communicable after effective treatment has been demonstrated for greater than 2 weeks, causing a significant reduction in symptoms.